Howdy folks, Kirk and Jason here with Kirk Giordano Plastering. Today I want to answer an old question. A fellow William, he called me like 6 months ago. He says, hey Kirk, can you show saddles and why they're supposed to be on the house? And I tell people, if you have a question, write it in. And when I get to that job, if I remember, I'll explain how we do it. So we just happened to come across a job. And we're going to do the bottom half. And he knew he had an issue up here. So he was asking me, well, what do you think I should do up there? And I said, well, you need saddles on there. He's like, well, I don't have a horse. Kidding. This is a saddle, guys. This is a metal saddle. Now, when they built this house, they didn't have saddles. So what they did is they used a tar paper, probably a very thick tar paper. And, oh, there it is right there. One layer of tar paper placed over the wood. All right. Now, that tar paper goes all the way up. And whatever caulking they had 80 years ago, they used. And guess what, guys? Caulking on tar paper is good for about 30, maybe 40 years. But what happens is all these saddles, like this saddle here, this saddle that came off of that one, and the saddle that Jake's working on, Jake Johnson, one of the better plaster lathers I ever worked with. I give him the easy job, the two-story job. I'll take this difficult one right here where I can sit on. Anyway, the purpose of this saddle here, if you notice, is metal. How long will a metal saddle last? 200 years, guys, especially if you go ahead and use not solder. That's the word I'm looking for, not caulking. I see a lot of these and they caulk them. I go, guys, you shouldn't caulk those. You should solder them. So this one's done well. It's soldered and it come off the corner up there that Jake's doing, just for an example. Here's how you do these, guys. Now, if you have a saddle, okay, on this roof right here, it's done well. It's a flashing over the roof, and that flashing incorporates a saddle. So the saddle's incorporated. Now what I do is I just now hung this weep screed. This is a weep or a drip screed. And Jake up there, he's... All right, you're a cage fighter, man. You're always looking for exciting work. That's exciting there, man. You get to hang off the ledge. All right, this is a weep screed, guys. Now, this fella here who put the flashing here, the roof flashing, incorporated his saddle. Now, what we do is I have to counter metal his saddle. So I've countered it, and I'm up about an inch from his. Now, his is on. Now, what we do, as a rule, is we go under it. See, this is all, it has a membrane here. It's all membraned out, but that I use as a precautionary measure, and the inspector is not going to know what's under here, so he's got to see what I'm doing. So what I'm doing is I'm sliding my two layers of 60-minute paper here. That's code now, guys. It used to be 10, it used to be 30, now 60-minute paper. I'm putting that under here. And if I see a membrane like this FortiFlash, what we generally do is what I already did. I already attached paper under this because it's a counterflashing. So if I'm going to redo it just to show you guys how to do it, this is how you do it. You take your flashing, your two-ply membrane, you put it down. Then you take the additional membrane for the window and you put that over it. Now with that over it, you just tack it down, guys. Now that is done. This wire can go over this saddle here. Yeah, when the stucco hits here, this takes a little bit longer to dry because the paper absorbs the stucco. The metal won't absorb it. Big deal. That doesn't faze us one bit. So moving on. Now, granted, I just used the paper that I have. So now I'm gonna wiggle my paper underneath the existing. I don't know if you could see this over here, Jay, but for example, guys, all right, when you're doing tie-ins with a saddle, I mean, you're going to take your paper. I'm just showing you this as an example, guys. You're going to take that paper, and you're going to slide it under. You slide it and slide it and slide it, and guess what? It's going to hit a nail or it's going to hit a staple, and that's as far as you can slide it. It's been broken out great. I mean, this is, we asked for 3 inches. Often there's times where there's not an inch of paper. They got 3 inches here, which is good. I've seen houses with no wire. The only thing holding up a garage is the stucco itself. So it rots, it deteriorates. It's like our bodies, man, use it or lose it. If they had painted this house or any other house in the USA or in the world, every 10 years, it'll last forever, guys. But the thing is, these saddles here, or if it didn't have a saddle, what happens is the sun hits it, it bakes it, it expands the wood just a little bit. You can't see it, but over 50 years, that expansion creates a tiny crack. That tiny crack, when it rains, water gets in it, swells the wood. The wood expands, thus you got your crack forming. And over the next 10 years, that crack that's 2 stories high, you can never see it. Who's going to climb up the house and look the top when they'd rather be at the beach? No one. But that crack, every winter when it rains, the water goes in it. It gets bigger, 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 until eventually you've got some wood rot going on. And this is common. This is just part of history, guys. If you don't paint it every 10 years and caulk it, you'll have to do something like this every once in a while. And this is what we do for a living, so I see it all the time. Anyway, so with a saddle, that prevents it. This will last 200 years right here. And what we do is we fish our paper in here. I'm going to paper here, continue the paper here, and go all the way up, and we take our new paper. Again, we fish it underneath this. Generally, what I'll do is I'll show you guys a little tip. I'll pull out the wire like this, and as I pull it out, it might take the hammer and just lift this just a little bit. That way, I'll show you, for example, our paper can go under it easier. You see how far that's going in? All I did, guys, was lift the stucco just a fraction of a hair, because that's all that's necessary. Now our new paper goes in, we've kind of fished it up there, and then we put caulking here. I'll tell you too, guys, what's really important is you use a good caulking. Us as contractors, I mean, I've been shopping at the plastering material yards for 40 years. Why? Because the plastering material yards used to sell, and they still do, they'd sell a Sikaflex polyurethane 1A. What is that? That is an adhesive caulking. It adheres to everything, and it's a sealant, so it seals. So when I put my new paper, and come around here, like right here, underneath this sill, I'm going to put a fat bead of this polyurethane caulking here and here, and I'm going to fuse that polyurethane caulking to the wood. That will last about 70, 80 years, and as long as you paint it and take care of it, you'll have no problems, guys. All right, guys, last thing we'll show you is the Sikaflex polyurethane caulking 1A. This stuff is an adhesive sealant. It sticks to everything. It is crazy nasty, but it works. And we were just turning the radio off because it's Friday and it was playing caulking about our penetrations, caulking around our penetrations. People try to put us down, caulking around our penetrations, just because we get around. Now you see this nasty stuff, guys? If it gets all over your gloves, just go all over here. But this is the shiat. It will hold three drops of this. Will hold 2 bricks together forever. And you just do that, that's sealing the paper into the stucco. Nothing could get in there. You caulk all your penetrations, all your holes. We're just listening to a song and laughing about it because it was talking about our generation. Anyhow, we thank you guys for watching, and as usual, we'll see you guys on the next one.
Hi folks, Jason here, and I'm here to tell you something you probably already know, that like most content creators on YouTube, my dad and I are members of the Amazon Affiliates program. What does that mean? That means that we can show and link you to some of the most commonly used tools in the plastering trade on Amazon, like our hawks and trowels, scoops, floats, and some of the other things, our battery-operated tools for breakout and cutting, etc. Now, if you buy those tools from those links, we earn a small percentage of that. That allows us to keep making these videos and keep putting out quality content for you folks to enjoy.
Once again, folks, we thank you for watching, and I really enjoy all your comments.
If you guys like this video, please click the like button down below. And also, if you enjoy what we do, subscribe to our channel so we can keep making these videos for you.
My name is Kirk.
And Jay.
We thank you for watching, and from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.